friend Ethan. Well, Ethan, you will be surprised, okay, to hear I and the wife took a little trip down to Boston last week to a tea party. And I guess you were thinking we will be getting the swelt head over being asked to a tea party in Boston. Well, Ethan, if you think that, you will be 100 miles off the track. Because, Ethan, I and Mary ain't the kind that gets a swelled head over being asked anywheres like some of our neighbors up here when they're asked anywheres. So you see, Ethan, even if we had been asked anywheres, we wouldn't have had no swelled head on account of being asked anywheres. Well, last Thursday, I and Mary drove old Bessie down to Boston. Bessie is our horse, you see, Ethan, which is about 13 miles from here to Boston. I mean, Ethan, as the crow flies, only no crow would ever fly to Boston if he could help it. Because all the crows that ever flew to Boston were shot by them Louise tavern keepers to make meals out of, Ethan. Oh, Rochester.
Yes, boss?
Gee up old Bessie for us, will you?
Yes, boss. Evening, Miss Livingston.
Evening, Rochester.
You know, Rochester, it may sound funny, but when I was just a little kid, I had a gorgeous, gorgeous head of golden locks.
You did, boss?
Yeah. In fact, my mother was so proud of them, she gave a curl to every one of our relatives.
Well, you better write to them, boss. It's time to get them back.
Now cut that out. Rochester, is there something wrong with my horse?
No, boss. Just English.
You know, Mary, I never tasted nothing so rotten in my life.
Oh, Jack, it wasn't that bad.
Them meals they have at Louise Tavern. And the prices. 3 shillings for a piece of steak about as big as my eye. And 4 pence for a cup of coffee? It's ridiculous. The streets ain't the only thing about Boston that's crooked, you know. Them tavern keepers is crooked, too.
Oh, Jack, Fanny E. Well Hall is all lit up like Charlie Davis on a Saturday night.
Well, let's go inside, Mary. I think it's free.
I bet you knew it was free before we came here.
Hey there, Jackson. Here for the tea party?
No tea.
Well, then we'll have coffee, for heaven's sakes. Now look here, madam. Do you want your tea and slavery?
No, just coffee.
You're a riot, Mary.
Madam, no tea shall ever land, baby.
No, but my husband will in about a minute.
Leave me out of this. Oh, waiter...
Yes?
Oh, not you.
Yes, it's me. What of it? Do you want your tea without tax? Are you one of those troublemakers?
Now look here, you. And I was just about to plank him one when the door behind us bust open and a lot of Indians come in yelling, "Everybody down to the Griffin's Wharf. There's going to be a tea party." Only Ethan, there wasn't Indians at all, but just the white folks dressed up like Indians, you see.
Hi, Mr. Benny.
Dennis, Don, what are you doing here dressed like Indians?
We're going to a tea party.
Yeah, Jack, you don't want us to drink our tea with tax.
Yeah, they get stuck in your teeth.
A one, a two, a Z, a zoo.
And I says to a fella, I says...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.